They're shielding as much as they can. Big Goose now has to keep himself tethered to Big Goose to keep alive for as long as possible. Shaz, take him down. Murdering found him. Hydration now going to turn around with the barrage to try and make the difference, but he's cut down. Great shield placement from Gesture. His bubble, it appears in midair. It blocks and causes all the splash damage of the barrage to be turned back on towards Hydration. He's done with the barrage. He's switching now to the Predator to try and...
Once upon a time, there was a man named Myro. This man was a Winston player, but not a normal type of Winston player. He did what no other tank had done before, using Winston as a highly aggressive tank used to secure kills and lead the path to dives. While he created the ideas, he was soon surpassed, though, by a player named Gesture. Gesture took his teachings and took them to their peak, having some of the greatest Winston plays ever, leading his team to the Season 1 trophy. Now that he was retired after 5 years of competitive Overwatch, I thought it would be a good idea to commemorate his journey. This is the story of Gesture. Gesture made his debut before the league began, playing with GC Busan, a competitive team supported by the city of Busan, in Apex Season 4 alongside the rest of his team, who would later join him in the Spitfire. Gesture became known for his aggressive style of Winston play, synergizing well with Prophet and Hua Reg, also becoming known for getting tons of value from his primal rages, killing the enemy's supports multiple times and generally being insanely clutch. The team ended up with a 4-2 record in regular matches and ended up winning the season after a close game against Runaway. Not too bad for their first tournament as a team. The team ended up disbanding after London picked up most of GC Busan and Cloud9 Kongdu for the premier stage of the league. Gesture continued to dominate in the league, while other notable main tanks like Myro were having a difficult time adjusting. Gesture proved that he was still at the top. Alongside his teammates, he dominated Stage 1 with a 7-3 record and reverse sweeping New York to become the first tournament winners of the league, and continued their dominance into Stage 2.
Their tanks as well, especially their main tank. Gesture was all over it. He didn't even die on their first playthrough of Dorado on that Winston. Very aggressive and was able to get away with a lot of crazy stuff. And then they brought, you know, Nuss in on the Ana to back him up. Gesture, so many final blows, so much disruption in the back line that really allowed the rest of London to have a lot of real estate space to work with.
The Tracer, Jinji and Winston dives that made them so efficient in Apex proved to be dominant yet again. However, he ran into a few issues that harmed his reputation a bit. He even looked solid while the team was imploding around him during stages 3 and 4. The only thing that slightly hurt his reputation was Fisher comparisons. For those who don't know or remember, Fisher played for the Spitfire but was always benched by Gesture, who most considered the better main tank, before Fisher was traded to the Gladiators for more playtime. After the trade, the Gladiators never lost a game to the Spitfire, and Fisher repeatedly taunted the Spitfire for letting him go. This led to many fans saying that Fisher was better than Gesture, and that the Spitfire kept the wrong off tank. Gesture never really got to prove he was the better player, unfortunately. But he did prove himself to be the best main tank in the world when he revealed to be the greatest Oryza in the world in playoffs despite not looking too hot on her before, helping lead the way to making the London Spitfire the first champions of the Overwatch League. However, in Season 2, things started to go a bit downhill. The dominant meta at the time, as we all know, was GOATS. The issue with that: Gesture's reign is mediocre to downright bad, which obviously made them exposed when dealing with top teams such as the Titans, Excelsior or Shock, or hell even Hangzhou Glads. Even when he was on the Winston, he got countered and struggled to make a big impact. This was slightly due to weirdness with the DPS and support rotations, but still. And in playoffs, when he was on Sigma, while Fury was on Zyria for whatever reason. Wasn't great. Overall, he hurt badly from the shift away from dive comps where he could run his signature Winston, and in Season 3 he was traded to the Soul Dynasty alongside his buddy Prophet. Would he fare better? Well, 2020 was an insanely weird season for the Dynasty. They had a ton of hype heading into the year, and they managed to take the Dragons, the best team in the region, to a 7-map thriller in the MAME Elite despite losing 9 maps in a row. However, it was after then things got a bit ugly. While these calls had been loud during the MAME qualifiers, after Seoul continued underperforming, people began calling gesture washed, that MAV1 should bench him and they should release him. His once world-class Winston had been far outclassed by players like Smurf, Fearless and Sado. Even when he was on ball he didn't look too good, with people continually calling for his benching in favor of MAV1. He still had a somewhat decent Doriza, but then something magical happened. The Season 3 meta occurred with a very unique shift. The tanks were Roadhog and Sigma. It was one of the strangest meters we've ever had. Who could prepare for this? Well, Gesture has been preparing for this his whole life, it seems like, and he ended up becoming the second best Roadhog out of nowhere. Shanghai, Gangzhou and even the Spark, who had dominated them up to this point, got destroyed by Seoul, with Gesture waving his amazing hog in their faces, taunting them, dominating them. The rest of Seoul rode his hog to a grand finals appearance against the Shock, where unfortunately his hog was just a bit worse than Super's, whose hog was just incredible. In all seriousness, this was his final elite showing. He nearly carried his team to finals by biffing Sado and MAV1 and making it to his second grand finals appearance. Unfortunately, that's where my praise of him ends. He was just outright washed on everything, he spent half of the time dying. He really showed by Seoul is the place where main tanks go to die, because his play got progressively worse as the season went on. Even his Oriza and Hog weren't effective. It's sad, but I can see why he chose to retire now. However, despite his lackluster Season 4, we have to commemorate his achievements regardless. He was the best Winston and Oriza in the world for 3 years straight, and his Hog helped carry his team to a grand finals appearance against all odds in Season 3. Thank you, Gesture. I wish you luck as you become a coach, and will remember you fondly. Thanks for watching and remember to like and subscribe for more. I upload daily Overwatch League content and am trying to hit 100 subs by Season 5, so any subscription helps greatly. Thanks.